Hi, do you want to know some ways you can help our local community out during this crazy coronavirus? I'm going to give you a few places you can donate money, a few things you can do that don't cost money, and then I'm going to give a little shout out to a few positive things I see going on during this time. So that's what I'm going to talk about today. Stay tuned. Hi, I'm Annie Baker. I'm a local realtor here in Silicon Valley. I specialize in selling homes and trusts and probate. I do weekly videos about real estate, but today I'm going to talk about what you can do to help our community during this crazy coronavirus. The first few options have to do with GoFundMe accounts. I'll post all the links to each GoFundMe below so you can choose which one, if not all, you want to donate to. So the first one I'm going to share has to do with a junior in high school. A junior in high school, Angelina Lue at Los Altos High School, started the GoFundMe account so that teens could get involved and chip in money to buy medical supplies for our healthcare workers. How great is that? So I think to date, the last I heard, they had purchased around 3,000 masks and donated them to the local hospitals. Bravo, Angelina, you are inspiring. The second one I'd like to share is from a local restaurant owner, Alex Holt. He owns Flights Restaurants. There's a couple locations, and honestly, he's doing a lot for our community right now. The GoFundMe account he started is called FeedTheNeed. He's gotten together with other local restaurant owners, primarily in Los Gatos, and a $10 donation is the equivalent of buying one meal for either a healthcare worker or possibly an elderly person in our community. So people can reach out and request meals, or people can nominate healthcare workers or departments or hospitals. What I also like about this is it isn't just for meal donations. They also have an aspect that local hourly employees like waiters and wait staff or bartenders can nominate someone in that field of work that they know is really struggling financially, and those people can have some financial resources given to them. So again, bravo, Alex, this is fantastic. You're helping not only some people get food they might not otherwise have, you're helping local restaurants, you're also helping some hourly workers that aren't making any money right now. And on a side note, Flights in Los Gatos has also created a drive-through in their parking lot where you can actually go pick up food, some meals, but they also have things like toilet paper and hand sanitizers that you can buy. So I love for people to support them as well. So the third GoFundMe account is brought to you by the owner of Sushi Confidential and Frost Cupcakes. The owner there, Andrea Boswell and Randy Mester from Sushi Confidential, got together and created this GoFundMe to provide meals to our healthcare workers. So if you know of anyone out there working in the healthcare field that could use a fantastic sushi lunch with Frost Cupcakes for dessert, go to their GoFundMe account. I also have to give a shout out to Randy, the owner of Sushi Confidential, and Andrea. They really have gotten together with some other local businesses to help each other. So for example, if you got takeout at Sushi Confidential, you could also get the Frost Cupcakes to go. You could also get Strike Brewing beer to go. So they're kind of helping each other out. I know Frost Cupcakes is also working with Villa Deli. So if you get takeout from Villa Deli in Willow Glen, you can also buy Frost Cupcakes. So kudos to you guys for all banding together and helping each other. Last but not least is Blvd Coffee. They have two locations, one in Los Gatos and one in Almaden Valley. And you can call up and they'll take donations to provide coffee and pastries to local healthcare workers. So they don't have a GoFundMe account, but call them. I've seen on their Instagram account, they've been bringing coffee and supplies to our healthcare workers. So bravo to you. So if you've been hit hard by financial times right now and you don't have the finances to donate, but you still want to get involved somehow, what about donating blood? Blood is at a real shortage right now, but if you're healthy and you think you're an acceptable candidate, check out the website for Red Cross for blood donation. And if you're crafty at all, there are a group of women that have band together to actually make masks. So you can either donate 100% cotton material or you can help actually sew them. So they have a Facebook group. It's called Cambrian Park Los Gatos Mask Makers. So donate your time, reach out to them, see how you can help. So to end, I would just like to give a shout out to our communities. A few things I've seen going on in my neighborhood, people are putting little teddy bears or stuffed animals in the window. So as people walk around, it's like a little treasure hunt. Find the stuffed animal in the window. It's a little game for kids. I know my husband and I like counting and seeing who gets the most when we walk our dogs at night. And I've also seen a lot of people are using chalk art to write positive messages. So all of us that are out walking more than even normal can read these positive messages. And so my final positive shout out goes to the radio station 106.5, The Mix. Every day at noon, they are playing our national anthem in solidarity of us banding together. It's all about us as individuals doing our part to shelter in place and flatten the curve. And honestly, it brings tears to my eyes every day because it's true. As long as we keep doing our part, we're going to get through this and we're going to get through it because of each other. So keep up the good work in our neighborhoods, checking in on our elderly. Be proud, Silicon Valley. We're going to get through this together. And until next time, I hope you stay safe, stay healthy, and stay positive. We're going to get through this. Have a good one.